Yo, Wagwan, it's that guy. It's not Locks, not Nation, man. I'm doing another video, of course. You know what it is? I am very intrigued by Dread Reviews, obviously, you know? And I love doing this type of content because it gets people out there learning about locks, embracing their locks and other people's locks, expanding the knowledge on the culture. And what I really notice is that there's not enough videos on the Marleys on my channel. Even though we've been rocking them out 5 years ago, we started doing some Bob Marley, Johann Marley, Stephen Marley, Damian Marley, Joe Mercer Marley videos. There's a lot of them I still never reviewed. So going back to the basics, I want to do the reggae classics here on out on the channel. So don't expect too many more rapper dreads reviews, because we go on back in time and we're gonna appreciate the goats out here. So today's video is on Rita Marley. So make sure you stay tuned, stay subscribed, because this is Not Nation. Rita Marley, known as Alpha Rita. I had no idea that Rita was short for Alpha Rita. So her name is Alpha Rita Constantia Marley OD. She is a Cuban-born Jamaican singer and the widow of Bob Marley. She was a member of the vocal group The Tree Eyes, or I Tree, along with Marcia Griffiths and Judy Mowat, who gained recognition as the backing vocals for Bob Marley and the Wailers. She was born July 25th, 1946, age 75, in Santiago de Cuba, in Cuba. Now her children, I know Marley's got a lot of kids with a lot of different women, but Rita Marley, the mother of Ziggy Marley, Sadella Marley, Stephen Marley, Sharon Marley, Stephanie Marley, and Sarita Stewart, and her grandchildren are Skip and Bambata Marley. A lot of people asking her what happened to Rita Marley lately. She suffered a serious stroke while visiting Miami last in 2016, which was her second stroke in her life. And, you know, real quick, strokes is a form of heart disease, and these can be beaten by eating Ital diet. Now, I don't know if Rita is on the Ital diet or not, but for strokes to take over someone's life twice, to me, it says that she's not. So maybe she is now. I don't know. Heart disease kills people every day, and it's the number one killer of humans in the world out there. So just a little info on that. So Rita Marley, let's see what she's got. Oh, looking at the profile, she's got those Afro texture going into play here. Gotta love that. Gotta love the Afro type 4 hair. Now, Rita Marley with her locks back in the day, these locks definitely were freeform. I know that. Looking at the new growth right on the scalp, there is definitely signs of that freeform life. Now, I know she wasn't doing the retwists or interlocking or anything back then, and her locks still came in just as thin as them. And of course, here's a photo of her with Bob Marley. His locks looking crazy righteous and super thick compared to hers, actually. And here's a shot of her with her locks. She's got the beads in there as well, looking great. I am a huge fan of the way that she wraps her locks up. Now, a lot of women with locks back then in Jamaica were doing this look, and it's phenomenal. To me, it's still like a goal to get to this level, to be able to know how to wrap my hair up in fabric like this is something I've never really done with my locks. You know, similar to right here, how Sizzla is rocking his locks. Yeah, it's a great look. So this is her daughter, Sadella Marley. She doesn't have the locks, so. You know, photos like this of Rita Marley with the headband, a real hippie-esque look, love it. Her locks just like so plentiful, I must say. And this is a throwback image. Jeez. This is Rita and Bob Marley on their wedding day. Crazy. Bob got married real young with her. He didn't even have the locks yet. And this era of Bob Marley is phenomenal because his music was more of like cover songs back then. And he would cover other artists like, you know, Western society music. And this was before his reggae scene. So very rare photo there. Very, very rare. This photo here, she shows us her locks wrapped up again. She didn't really wear Tams, but she wore the wraps a lot. And as we can see, really big on the dreadlock jewelry. Really big on the jewelry. Dreadlock jewelry, definitely a big staple in her culture. Often wearing like seashells or metal clasps, but always with the scarf. Now this photo here shows us her hair when it was wet. She was probably coming out of a waterfall or the ocean. So it looks fantastic. Here's another photo of that right here. Doing a little skinny dipping. Photo of her with her locks on top of her head with like a kind of a half wrap. Now these scarves are actually pretty big. So once I get my hands on one of these, I'm gonna try and figure out how to wrap my hair up. Furthermore, if any of you guys have any videos or tips on how to do this, I would love to learn firsthand. And now here's a cool Rasta scarf that she's got going on. Loving the African colors that she's wearing. But more so, she always had her locks wrapped up. Kind of crazy. Yeah, I'm not sure why that would be. Here's her locks when she's a little bit more elderly in 2021. Looking a bit more loosey at this point, I guess I would say. Interesting Tam here. She's the queen of different wraps for her hair. Really hard to do a dread review on her locks when she doesn't really show them that much. I must say, this wrap looks sick. This is a knitted scarf. Much like a knitted Tam, but this scarf, you know, it does the same features essentially. And you can see her locks hanging out the back of them. So it's a cool way to wrap your hair up without having them fully wrapped up. Say she wants to show them out still. Another fantastic hair Tam, hair wrap, Tam wrap. I'm gonna call them a Tam wrap. You know, and again here, the wrap with her hair coming out through the back. You know, Afro days before the locks. Maybe a bit more recently. These locks looking a bit more manicured than the ones in the past that she's had. But she's definitely holding it down. And this is the photo of her in the wheelchair after the stroke. So we can see that her health is actually deteriorating. You know, best of wishes and best of health to you, Alpha Rita. Our prayers are with you to get better and healthy. Itel is vital. And we can see that she doesn't have locks at all anymore. You know, so that's the way life goes. You know, you have locks your whole life and something might happen one day where you're just like, you know what, I'm done with locks and I gotta continue my journey as is. You know, and just a little throwback photo here of her really young Rita Marley with the short hair. So definitely a inspirational woman of reggae. And we truly appreciate what you've done for the culture and the amount of inspiration that you've given people to stay dedicated yourself. So Rita Marley, you're going down in the history books as a legend, as a goat of the freeform locks. And you know, big ups to everybody out there, all the women out there looking to freeform. Look at some classic Rita Marley photos to get some dreadspiration for yourself. And this is a sick Ethiopia tab that she's got rocking here. That is amazing. Oh, and speaking of which, there's another amazing Tam here as well. Without her locks in, though. Crazy. Word up. But anyways, that's it. I'm gonna end this video here. You know what it is. Rita Marley, Dread Review in the books. You know, no woman, no cry, as Bob Marley say. And just keep on keeping. You know, I don't really have much more to say on this Dread Review, but I'm just happy to be back doing these in full force. And the main thing about it is that, you know, I might have taken a break on the channel for a little while. There was some things I was going through. To be honest, you know, maybe a little bit of, I don't want to say depression, but like a sadness or just like a lack of motivation or a lack of purpose kind of was happening. But I was watching a Tyler, the Creator interview yesterday, and basically he reignited my flame of just about being yourself and just having drive and passion. Really comes down to caring. You have to care about something in life. You got to care about a lot of stuff, but when it comes down to finding a purpose and really sharpening your skills at something that you're really good at, you have to care. So whatever it is in your field that you do and you want to become the best at it and be known for it, you have to care about the people in the niche, the work that you're doing, about everything. So I've just realized that I truly really do care about helping people of the world attain knowledge of the dreadlock culture. And this knowledge is gonna help people inspire to go for it. And I wanna be there to help guide people along the way, because not everyone can make that jump, that leap by themselves, because they have outside forces that are telling them, no, you can't have this, no, you can't grow your hair like that. But when you come across a Knot Nation channel and you meet this guy named Knot Locks, he's gonna help you cast away that toxic energy and really just focus in on your soul purpose and your self-beliefs to help you cultivate the best locks from within naturally. Because we all essentially need to return back to the roots. And going natty is returning to our roots and allowing our roots to lock up the way they're supposed to lock up. The way that all hair types will lock up if left be. So yeah. Anyways, I'm rambling. I'll see you guys in the next video. Buy some merch. Leave a comment. Like the video. Hell yeah. See you guys next time. Peace out and love. I'm gone. Adios.